on the break of night, and the pink skies waving goodbye. You come on the break of night, leaving no traces around, around. She's trying to free her reckless heart. She's trying to be as light, as light as the breeze. The queen of art, Friday morning.
Jay Shrek, I'll tell you what, I'm on the trail today. I've been to Agua Fria twice in 1 week, which is pretty rare. I've been looking for Olla Negra. I've been hiking my ass completely off my body. I failed last time I was out here. I've got some coordinates. I found some coordinates in the purple book, and I had a guy I'm going to call the Raven, who helped me dial in that location close to an area which I thought I was at before. So I'm super excited about getting out here today. And I've got my coordinates wrapped in. I actually got my GPS. I've got the coordinates that I believe is where it's at. It says 0.75 from here, straight across. I can either go through the creek or I can go across the top of the mountain. I'm going to go across the top of the mountain today. I don't know why, but it says I'm 0.78, which shouldn't be bad. The hiking's horrible, but look at this road. Talk about a horrible road. That is a horrible road. So what we're going to do is, you know, I have been hunting and hunting and hunting for this location forever. And anybody that follows me knows that this is like one of the last things that I've been trying to track down forever. You know, enough where, you know, normally I don't go out here by myself, but today it was like, man, I have to get out here. I have to see, and I have to find this place. Quite a few people out here today. I've seen 6-7 Jeeps out here. It's a day after Veterans Day, so a lot of people probably took a long weekend. And so I'm going to try. Oh, look, see how close you just come right here? Look at that. That's Agua Fria right there in a nutshell. Look at that ridge. Look at that lip. So we had ruins all the way through here, all the way across here, squalls down there. On this top of this hilltop is ruins. So we got ruins everywhere. It says I need to go about that direction, which is through there, but I'm going to have to go around the mountain. So, you know what? This might be a good way. It may be a bad way. Look at there. Again, I'm not even looking for shards today. But it's going to be a little rougher hiking across this than it would be going through the bed. But it's definitely going to be shorter if I can kind of do a shortcut through here. And so I don't know if this is a good idea or a bad idea. But I've made my commitment. It's not that I couldn't change it. Look how beautiful that grassland looks. I just love this place. You know... Man, I have been working so hard to try to make this thing go. So we're going to get the sunglasses on and start getting this hiking on the journey. And again, we're only going 0.78. So even though that's probably double that hiking anywhere else, but I was so excited when I thought I found the location. I better watch what I'm doing because I can't get hurt today by myself out here. Yellow shirt, if you'll notice. You know, the other day, Joe B was way down the valley, and I could see him in his white shirt, and I thought, you know, it's smart to have a brightly colored shirt on when you're out here so you can see people, or they can find you if they need to, God forbid. They can see you. Now I am armed today. There's a truck down there. So let's get this adventure going. You know, right here, I just stopped, take just a breather. Look at all the shards. You know, I think I'm in the middle of nowhere, but there had to been something out here, some type of habitat for there to be shards out here. No possible way. Get a look at this here. Right across that mountain is where it says I'm supposed to be. So we'll see how that works up. It says I'm 0.54. You know, one thing, I'm always in a hurry. And one thing I'm trying to really do today is take my time, watch the ground, try not to twist my ankle. But you know, this is a site here for sure. This little site. I mean, you wouldn't have this amount of pottery shards in this area if this was not a location. And they're all, I mean, they're scattered. There's millions of them. Now we know there is things over here. There's ruins over here all the way along. We know they're all over that ridge line. We know that Brooklyn's on the other side of that. We know all that. But here's another area that I've never looked at as a camp. And then you see these places like this, and whether it is or not, it looks like a roasting pit. You know, it's still, the ground's gone. And, you know, I can see them being in this little area right here. So I guarantee you there was a village right in here as well. You know, it shows that I've been a quarter of a mile. I've got a half mile to go. So, you know, we're making pretty good time. We're just taking our time, trying to enjoy the journey today. Watch where we're walking. John knows where I'm at. He knows exactly where I'm going to be. I even told him the exact path that I was going to take. So, God forbid if somebody should have to come try to find me, I shouldn't be too difficult. And I've already seen a bunch of buzzards. So if you see those same buzzards over here, well, that's where you probably ought to go. But we're gonna take our time and decide on the way back if we're gonna come back this way or not. But you know, we should be over this ridge. But I don't know what I'm going to get into when I get into the face of that other mountain. I don't know how difficult that's going to be. So you're always thinking about that. Now, I am going to a rock shelter, which would be shelter for an animal. So I am going to be armed, hopefully not harmed, to be able to, you know, make sure that he doesn't get a little pissed off if there's something in this house. Because, you know, we have everything up here. You're going to have mountain lions, bobcats, all of it. So where are we at now? What are we up to? What does the meter say? 0.46. This is the third trip up here. I've actually been in location four times, but the third time actually looking for this location just to go to show you how, you know, just because you want to find something, you know, the work that goes into it's ridiculous. And because I failed twice before, man, to tell you, I'm not apprehensive, I'd be lying. And again, the way I decided to go, when I peek over, I don't know what I'm getting into. Which this is where it gets tough, because at a high grass, you can't see what you're stepping on. So this is when your leg rolls. 0.22, straight across, 0.22. Man, I was there. Not only do I was there, I wouldn't get to it. If not, I'll have to cross this peak right here and have to roll that way right across. And then again, I don't know if this is it or not. I mean, I've thrown all my eggs in one basket now. That's all I got. You know, I don't know if I can get out here a fourth time. You know, unless I would have to know exactly. So, you know, there's a point where, you know, you got to put the time in. If you're not going to put the time in, you're not going to find the stuff. Man, I'm having a bitch time coming through here. This is tough coming across this ridge line. You know, anytime you think you've got it made in this terrain, or you think it's right there, this place comes back and bites you in the ass. Look at this. Glad you guys are with me. Holy shit. Holy shit. Yo. Man, cat claws are just ripping me apart. Jesus. Ah. Holy shit. There it is. Holy shit. Look at that. Oh my God. Damn. Man. Holy shit. Holy shit. Look at that, dude. How beautiful is that? How beautiful is that? Oh my God. That is the most gorgeous hole I've ever seen. Man. Look at that, boy. Something's been back there digging too, boy. They were using to repurpose the nest. Look at this place. Oh my God. How cool is this? Look at this. Olla Negra. I'm guessing this is one, and I'm guessing two is around there. Holy shit. How awesome is this? Man. Look at this thing. I don't know if I'd ever seen it. I knew yesterday when I saw that style of rock right there, I knew that it was probably in the wrong place. Okay, they would have made six digs in here, a meter by a meter, which is 3x3. So they had dug six times in here. They would have dug six basic holes in this place. How incredible is this? Now it's somebody else's home, which I think is really neat as well, actually. Man, look at that. Look at this place. Man, it took me forever to find this. You got to be kidding me. Damn. Well, I'm about as excited as I can get. You know, let's take a look and see what my phone said as far as what they found in here. Now, there's supposed to be special pottery in here from the Paya people, P-A-O. And there's supposed to be such a unique black pottery shards that there's only 12 examples of this in the United States, which made this the first place that was ever excavated in, I believe, 67 in Agua Fria. So it shows you the importance of this. Now, I'm going to read real quick, if I can see my phone, what they found in here. So they did a dig in here, 6x6, basically a meter by a meter, which means that's 3x3. So they did six digs in here. And in that digs, they found buttons off a cavalry jacket, a Civil War era. So there was probably Apache scout that used this to get out of the weather. But they also found different shards. But what's incredible is this was the first dig ever in Agua Fria in 67. And what they found was black shards, which meant there was black pottery. Thus, Olla Negra, black pot, which was fabulous. And now they think maybe it might not have been from the Powell people, which they believed it was. But at that time they did. And this was one of the most important places anywhere for archaeology in the Southwest at one time. How incredible is this to find this finally? And I can see why I couldn't see it before. It's because the way the slope runs, you can't see it from the ground. So no wonder I've been searching and searching and searching three times here to find this location. This is the most beautiful rock shelter I've ever seen. People say there wasn't a lot to it. It was unassuming. This is beautiful to me because this is a hell of a lot of work, and I couldn't do it without the Raven, Joe B., John, everybody on Black Flag. Man, I can't thank you guys enough. This is absolutely incredible journey. Jace Rick, Black Flag! This is absolutely unbelievable. What an incredible place. Wow. I couldn't be any more excited than I am today. What an incredible journey. Incredible opportunity to see this. You know, there's another smaller outlying shelter down there. I'm going to make a loop around this edge just to see if I can see it. But now I got to get back safe. That's all I got to do. Jace Wreck, Olla Negra. I love you. I just come around here to just go, okay, let's see if there is two. Look at this one. Holy shit. Holy shit. I don't know if this is one or two. It's got to be. This is the big one. Look at this thing. Holy crap. Man, look at all the rocks that stumbled, falling down. I want to be careful on this one. Man, how cool is this? Boy, something's living back up in there. Don't want to meet them today. Do need to get up in there as best I can. Wow, that goes way back there. Let's see if we can't get the camera back up in there. I can't crawl back there because the rocks are holding me off. Look at that. Look how far that goes back in there. Holy crap. Look at that. Oh, my God. Man, that goes way back there. Man, look at this dude. Look at this. Holy crap. Look at that view. Man, I didn't even expect this one to be the big one. This is where they did the 6 meters. Holy crap. Look back in there. That thing goes way back there. At least 16 to 18 feet back there. Oh, my God. Look at this thing. Now, this is beautiful. Man, I didn't even realize that this was the one. Look at that. Oh, man. Woo! I can't even believe this. Look at that thing. God only knows what's in here. Wow. Man, I've never been double excited. Usually I'm single excited, but I thought that was it. This is it. This is Olla Negra 1 right here. Right here. And this Olla Negra 2. And I don't know if this animal's been digging back in there, but it goes way back there. It goes way back there. Look at this thing. How incredible is this? Man, I tell you what. I couldn't be any more excited than I am right now. What a beautiful day. You know, they did 6 digs in here. A meter by meter, they found 3 different types of shards in here. They found a old rusty knife.
They found an ancient knife. They found buttons off a jacket from the cavalry during the Civil War era. So probably an Apache scout was up in here staying the night, getting out of the weather. What an incredible journey. I can't even believe it. I'm so stoked. Well, we've been searching for Olla Negra 1 and 2 forever. You know, in this very rock shelter, they found different types of shards. They found ancient knives. They found a piece of a sandal weaving. They found black shards, which is why this is called Olla Negra. Now, a lot of people today dispute the fact that this is from the Pao, P-A-O tribe, which would be extremely old. And what an incredible find. I can't even believe this. I can't even believe we found this thing after all this time. I am so stoked. I can't even believe this. I'm so pumped up. I just want to thank everybody's help, man. Look at this, man. This is incredible. Absolutely incredible. Man, I think it's time to get on down the trail. Bam, I'm so happy. That is awesome. Let's get the hiking out of here now. Holy crap, look at that. Look how deep that is. Holy crap, look at the water standing. That's incredible. I never looked over there. Look at that. Look at that. That's the next thing I'm going to try to do. And I'll take you with me, because that way if I do bust my ass, you'll be able to see it. Which I know a lot of you, there's at least a couple thumbs down that would like to see that. There's a lot of thumbs up that doesn't, but there's thumbs down that would like to see that action. So I'm going to try to disappoint the shit out of them by standing upright. Boy, those hawks, when they screech, are ridiculous. Oh, I just got stuck. Look at that. Oh, man. You know, I just saw the truck over the horizon, and look how big these grasshoppers are. Those things are huge. I don't think I've ever seen a grasshopper that big. So whatever eats grasshoppers is going to be huge this year. So we're going to have lizards as big, so big you can ride them. That's crazy. You know, it's kind of funny is I don't even see the tracks that we had that were here Wednesday to kind of show you how tracks go. I don't even see them, and I know it didn't rain. So, I mean, I can see some indentations, but I can't see any footprints. So it just goes to show you can kind of tell how old tracks are on the trail. They don't last that long. So, not that that might be important to you or not. It's nice to know you're somewhere that somebody is or isn't. Okay. Holy shit. We just saw the weirdest thing happen. One of the weirdest things I've ever seen happen. There's a mine, and I've walked by this mine I don't know how many times. I don't know how many times I've walked by this mine and never seen it. I'm in mining area now, so. Holy shit. I don't know if that got you guys, but God, I've never seen this mine. You've got to be kidding me. Now you don't want to watch for snakes. I don't know how far it goes back. We're not going to get too crazy, but wow. Doesn't look like it goes back that far.
Now, there it is. It stops there. Wow. Never knew this was here. Holy crap. See how many times you can walk by something? If it wouldn't have been for them birds, I would have walked right by that. Just goes to show you never know what's out here. They had a feeling to do a test mine there, that maybe because of that white rock above. What a great adventure today, man. I've had a gas. At least we see the truck. That's always a good sign. Doesn't mean you're there, but at least we see the truck. There's a shortcut there, but again, that's an animal shortcut. I had a big doe. There you are, right there. See it? Whitetail. Right up there. You probably don't see it, but come out of that brush. So we already saw the baby. I don't know if that's mama or not, but that's that one's mama. But yeah, I've been ripped up enough. I think I'll just get back into the creek. You know what the most beautiful sound you can ever hear after you get done hiking and you're in Agua Fria is this right here. I always got a jumper box, but I always feel a lot better when I hear that sound. Chase Rack.
7 million businesses around the world.
Chase Rack and the radio works. That's good too. Adios, amigos.